The champs. Here come the champs. Bring on the champs. Kirsten Moore Towers, Michael Marinaro. Got to the top of the mountain a year ago, finally. Got a chance to go to the Worlds again. Finished seventh. They like the view. They want to stay there.
They also know their short program score last year was just over 71 to win the short. And they've got two teams hot on their heels here. It's going to demand their best. Oh, speed right up the top.
What you want from me? What you want from me? In a
watch the quality marks.
Tumble out of that triple jump.
Been the synchronicity.
Oh, and babe, I'm just fine with that. Just to get close to you.
You see the number, technically, marked down on the GOE on the side-by-sides. And Kirsten and Michael, they're perfectionists. They know they had that little slip-up on the side-by-sides. Not egregious. We'll see how it affects their mark. Final pairs team, MTM. Kirsten Moore Towers and Michael Marinaro, great pairs champions, also very good mathematicians. She knows all the numbers. She knows the scores.
Right. She's hanging around with Megan Duhamel, that's why. And keeping score as they go. So they were able to pick up some good GOEs that will cover the deficit in the GOE for the one jumping error. A lot to like again about that program, and it's figuring out the differences, what they did do well. So let's take a look at this triple twist. Very clean, picking up GOEs on that entrance to the loop. Looking back and really weaving these elements in, and you know, can you get a better back on the landing of that triple loop rod? And so let's watch carefully here. This is the first one I've seen Kirsten this year.
And just do a kind of a step out at the end.
That's it.
Didn't hit the ice, so no deduction.
You're right. Not a major deduction, nope, that's for sure. Flying through the air, and just the details, the way she turns her head and looks up.
And the second mark should help elevate that, too. And the champs, really the only bobble in that final flight. We almost had Paris perfection. We could have a fight tomorrow, and we will. This is very close. Again, that second mark and the GOEs, you said that elevated them up to take away the deficit. They're still the leaders, 73-73. Again, only 2.5 points separating first and second.
And just over three first, second, and third. Yeah, over three.
We've come to expect that at the Nationals in the pairs, though, haven't we?
Well, and these teams, my goodness, did they put on a show. Really?
It was good. And keep in mind, there's only two.
Only two.
That go to the Worlds in Montreal. And so that battle for second place is going to be enormous tomorrow.
No room for error.
No. More Towers and Marinero, the defending champions lead. Here's Sarah.
Thank you so much, Rod. A mistake that we don't typically see from you. What happened on the jump?
I'm not sure. I think a little bit of lack of focus at the last second. The jump felt really good. It looked good on the replay. So a bit of a bummer that I won't make tomorrow.
Well, when you look at it, though, first going into Saturday's skate, though, what becomes the mindset when you're looking at the way that the standings are right now?
Same thing as today, I think.
Yep. We've struggled with the short program a little bit this season, so doing a good, strong short, setting us up in the place we want to be for the long tomorrow is exactly what we want to do. We're going to obviously build on that from today, and we have more to give tomorrow, but we're ready to come tomorrow with our A game and lay it down.
We look forward to seeing it. Thank you, you too.
Thank you.
Rod Tracy.
Last year, they were the